Looking at your numbers here and improvements across the board, improvements in revenue, improvements in profit, improvements in liquidity. If you had to point out one core driver for this quarter, what would it be?
Liquidity, the last point you touched on, the most important thing for us, not only as a company, but as a sector, is getting liquidity back into the market. So it's cash that is our fuel in the tank. It's cash that keeps us going. So that's the big driver for the half has been chasing receivables and liquidity.
Now, obviously, we knew you were coming in, so we put together some property prices. And I want you to deconstruct this for you. We put together Abu Dhabi property prices over the past 5 years, Dubai property prices over the past 5 years, and this year. It doesn't look good. I mean, Abu Dhabi down 17%. Dubai down 17% over the past 5 years. But you would actually counter this, and you would say, look, it is not all about, let's say, the residential side of the business. What makes you a little bit more confident maybe than these charts tell us?
Well, I think there's a couple of things in regard to property. Property prices, what you're describing, are the sale prices potentially of the asset. We're the contractor and we don't just build property. When property is built, you've got roads, you've got power, you've got all the other utilities, social, economic infrastructure. We're a general contractor, so part of our market is building villas, part of it is building apartments, but we're also doing hotels. We've just finished the Louvre, we're doing midfield terminal in Abu Dhabi. So, our business is diversified across the whole of the construction sector.
It's been remarkable the last 3 months for Arabtec. It's how the stock has performed in comparison to your peers. But year to date, property stocks have gotten quite a drubbing. Mm. What is your take on the health of UAE property right now? You say that you're diversified, and we'll get into some of the other markets you're in a bit later, but if you had to summarize where we are in the cycle when it comes to property, what would it be?
Well, I think you've got to look at the UAE over the last 20 years, and there's no question the property or population growth has been a huge driver to the economy, but it's starting to get larger. It's a much larger base, much larger country now, population base. So yes, eventually if you're growing 10% of a million or 5% of 10 million, it's a very different a scenario, size of market. So us, yes, we are linked to property, but we're not only linked to property. As I said, we're a general contractor. So I think too many people just look at the market here and just only look at it through the lens of property, where you have to start looking through the lens of all the sectors of the economy.
Can I ask you then, in paragraph 3 in your report, you talk about expansion, you talk about the geographies, and we're very familiar with where you want to expand. But if you have to rank that in terms of Saudi Arabia, Bahrain, and Egypt, where is the number one destination for you to deploy capital, let's say, in the next 18 months? Because your game is not this month, next month, or next quarter. So where is the key region for you for growth?
Well, the first thing, you just mentioned three countries outside of the UAE, and they are the only three countries we're focusing on. So the primary market for us long-term is Saudi. Secondary market would be Egypt, and then third is Bahrain. We're doing the airport in Bahrain at the moment. We're doing some work for Emaar and Egypt, and we've got quite a large business in Saudi Arabia, and obviously a huge pipeline under the current vision for the country.
As you look to the remainder of this year and beyond, you've got an ambitious backlog you need to deliver on. That will need probably some financing. What are your plans for later this year?
I think firstly, we're not a bank, so this is the problem with liquidity. Contractors shouldn't be financing their backlog. We should be carrying it, executing the backlog, delivering the backlog, and then converting that into revenue and liquidity. So our primary focus is to make sure that we get paid for what we do, and also to keep that strong momentum. $4.81 billion, is a huge revenue for the group, and we're growing quarter on quarter, and we continue to plan to do that.
So that's a no in terms of financing plans for this year?
We're always looking at refinancing, but a contractor is meant to use its backlog to deliver its revenue, or its balance sheet to deliver its revenue.
You touched briefly there on the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Obviously, there's a huge amount of news flow over the past couple of days. You're there, you travel there. What is the reality about investment on the ground? What is the pace and velocity of change in the kingdom?
I think for me, there's a couple of things that I see. I look for tangible, visible signs of a change of a strategy. I've been going to Saudi Arabia since the early 90s, and what's happening there at the moment is transformational. And You know, yesterday I met with someone incredibly senior in regard to the master plan of the Red Sea, and you know, just looking at what's planned there, and it's not just a vision. The vision is now starting to be translated into actually projects, opportunities. So we're expecting to start seeing.
Could I ask you for a dollar figure on the opportunity? What could be in there for Arabtec in terms of a real possibility?
If you look, our backlog currently sitting at $16 billion. Yeah. It's heavily weighted towards Dubai, followed by Abu Dhabi, and then followed by Saudi Arabia. After Expo 2020, I could see, you know, that shift, that Saudi becomes the largest component of our backlog and revenue in the future.
What is the balance in terms of priorities? I mean, domestic versus your international exposure. If you could choose to tilt it in either way in the next 3 to 5 years, how would you shape that?
I don't tilt it geographically. We only look at geographic as far as risk, geopolitical risk. We look at the sectors at which we provide our services in. So ideally for us, we provide it in services where we can add value. So looking at, you know, infrastructure, social economic infrastructure, looking at, you know, the residential market that we're doing in the way of villas, population growth. So, you know, for us, it's not about geographic expansion. For geographic expansion's sake, it's about providing construction services where they're needed. And we see, you know, the need longer term, certainly going past Expo, shifting towards KSA.